Assalamu alaikum. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, I am back after a Ramadan break. Today, I will be talking about a very important issue. Why do the Christian missionaries hate on Islam so much? Why do they insult the Prophet so much? Is this something new? I will be talking about a number of reasons as to why they have to do. Among those reasons are money. A lot of them receive a lot of money. They do it simply, purely for money, to make money. It is a money-making enterprise. They receive money from Islamophobic establishments. They are part of the Islamophobic industry out there, whether it's in the US, whether it's in Europe, or wherever they may be. They are being funded by the Islamophobic industry. That's one reason. Another reason is they may be genuinely Islamophobic. They may dislike things in Islam. You know, it might be the case that they don't know much about Islam. They don't study Islam much. They read things online and they become the enemies of Islam and Muslims and the Prophet of Islam. Another reason is that this is a historic trend to take away Christians from Islam. Now, almost everyone knows that Islam is the fastest growing religion in the world. It is growing in Africa. It is growing in South America. It is growing in Southeast Asia and countries like Philippines. It is growing very fast in India. Okay, so what are the Islamophobes doing, in particular Islam hating Christian missionaries? What tactic are they using? Okay, and some of them, they know well that they are lying on Islam. They know well they are painting a very extremely unpleasant image of the Prophet of Islam. They know well that they twist and manipulate the sources of Islam. The question is, why are they doing it? Why are they doing it? The answer is in history. There is this book you must look at. It is titled The Martyrs of Cordoba, and it is authored by Jessica A. Koop. Jessica A. Koop has published this book titled The Martyrs of Cordoba. Who were the martyrs of Cordoba? In the 9th century, there was a group of Christians who saw that Islam is spreading massively, very, very rapidly in Spain, in medieval Spain, because we know that in the year 711, Muslims had arrived in Spain. The Jewish inhabitants welcomed them as liberators because the Jews were facing immense persecution at the hands of the Catholic Church. So a lot of the Jewish people supported that particular takeover of the Iberian Peninsula on the part of the Muslims. So after that, the Muslims established a firm government in Spain. And in the 9th century, almost a century later, or maybe 150 years later, the influx of Christians coming into Islam was massive. So why were they coming to Islam? Because they were reading Islamic philosophy, they were reading Islamic works, they were reading Islamic theology, they were reading Arabic books in the Arabic language. Okay, Christian youngsters were reading Arabic books. And Jessica A. Koop quotes a 9th century author from Spain. His name was Paul Alvarez. Paul Alvarez wrote that all the Christian youngsters are reading Arabic commentaries, Arabic literature, Arabic philosophy, and due to that, they are becoming highly impressed by the Muslim civilization, and the outcome is that they are becoming Muslims. So this was a huge problem for some Christian missionaries or some Catholic clergy in Spain at the time. So they came up with an idea. The idea was to go so extreme in their criticism of Islam that it simply removes any sympathy from the minds of the Christian audiences. Okay, or the tactic was that they will go and insult the Prophet of Islam in the Muslim domain. They will come to the Muslim courts, Muslim public places, and they will shout and scream insults against the Prophet of Islam, which was, by the way, illegal in medieval Spain, which was governed by the Islamic law. Okay, it was illegal to insult God. It was illegal to insult any prophet of God, for that matter. So these people would come out in public and they would insult the Prophet of Islam openly, publicly. This was not an academic exercise. This was simply to attract attention. This was simply to gain sympathy of the Christian masses. How? Of course, it was illegal. So it was but natural for the state, the Muslim state of Spain, okay, to reprimand these people, okay, and put them on trial. A lot of these Christians were put on trial and they were punished. They were severely punished because they insisted on insulting the Prophet of Islam, even in the courthouses, in front of judges. And it was illegal by law to do so. So were they good Christians? This is a question you may have to answer, because of course the Bible states that you obey the law, right? The New Testament writings of Paul, they clearly state that render unto Caesar what is Caesar's and render unto God what is God's, right? Very often Christian scholars interpret these verses as follows, that these verses are telling us to obey the law of the land, don't break the law. So these Christian missionaries, activists, extremists, Islamophobes, Islam haters, the haters of the Prophet of Islam, they were deliberately breaking the law in order to gain sympathy from the Christian masses. So when they were put on trials, what they were trying to do, when they would be punished, they knew that this will basically gain sympathy in the minds of the Christian masses, and they will start hating Islam and Muslims, because these so-called martyrs of Cordoba were being punished by the Muslim state for breaking the law, for insulting the Prophet of Islam in public. So this was a tactic on their part which failed miserably, because most Christians rejected it. Most decent Christians, even at the time, they rejected this approach. The majority of the Christian clergy and the masses, they said, we have nothing to do with these extremists. These people, they have nothing to do with us. Okay, we are living peacefully with the Muslims and we love the freedom we have, right? So most Christians fortunately rejected it. So this movement took off for about 10 years, from the year 850 to 859 to be precise. Jessica A. Koop documents the details in this book, a very, very interesting read, The Martyrs of Cordoba. Why they were insulting Islam and the Prophet of Islam, and what did they achieve, and what happened to them, right? So these are very important questions. Christian missionaries today, Islam-hating Christian missionaries, to this day, they are using this tactic. They know they have nothing good to preach. They don't have the original message of Jesus Christ. What they have is a corrupt version of the teachings, or some of the teachings of Jesus Christ. What they have is a corrupted scripture, they call the Bible. They know they cannot fully, satisfactorily, with confidence, teach from this scripture, because people ask questions. So what they have done now, they have shifted attention completely to Islam, and they're making money out of hating Islam. They are trying to gain converts back from Islam to Christianity. Okay, they lie on Islam and Muslims and the Prophet of Islam. They deliberately put evil twists and they manipulate the sources of Islam, even the life of the Prophet. They use derogatory terms to describe the Prophet of Islam. They deliberately insult the Prophet of Islam. But will they succeed is the question. They will never succeed. They will never succeed, because the truth stands clear from falsehood. The truth stands out. People who are seeking the truth, genuinely, those who really want to know what the true image or the true message of Islam is, they will go and search. So I strongly recommend this book to get a historic context on as to why Christian missionaries are doing this today. They could be preaching from the Gospels. They could be telling the Christians and the Muslims about the love of the Gospels. Okay, we hear the Christians always talking about the love the Gospels have to share. Where is that love in these Christian missionaries? And amazingly, a lot of these hateful, hate mongers, Islamophobic Christian missionaries are being supported by the mainstream Christian missionaries, who do not themselves use the same language these bigots are using, but they have the support. You can see them often appearing on the same platforms with these extremist bigots who have nothing to share but hate, right? So the good news is their tactic will not succeed. Their insults against the Prophet of Islam, their extreme language against the Prophet of Islam and Islam, and the twisting of our sources is not going to succeed, because every single attempt in the past failed. It fell miserably. And even this will pass. Okay, Islam will stand clear from falsehood. Islam stands on its own terms. So these missionaries will fail. They will miserably fail, because their predecessors have failed, right? There is another book I would like to strongly recommend as to how the Catholic Church systematically demonized Islam and Muslims and the Prophet of Islam throughout the Middle Ages. That book is Islam and the West, Making of an Image. Islam and the West, Making of an Image by Norman Daniel. The author is Norman Daniel, and or Daniel Norman. And this particular book is a compilation of history that documents as to how the Catholic Church and Christian clergy throughout the Middle Ages were tarnishing the name of Islam and Muslims and the Prophet of Islam to keep the Christian masses away. This is exactly what the Christian missionaries are trying to do today. They know Islam is spreading in the Christian lands, in South America, in mainland Europe, and also in North America and in Southeast Asia. Islam is spreading very, very fast. So this is the new way. Actually, it's not a new way. It is quite historic, but it is a tactic the Christian missionaries are using today to go extreme against Islam, go very, very, very repulsive, go very, very, very insulting against Islam, insult the Prophet of Islam, use derogatory terms, use derogatory language to tarnish his name and his image. And the Christians who are listening, they will never think of Islam. And why they're doing this, to repeat the point again, because they have nothing good to teach themselves. These Christian missionaries, these Islamophobes, have nothing to share from Christianity. They don't have any truth to preach. What do they have to preach from? Trinity, the doctrine of the Trinity, that doesn't make sense. The doctrine that Jesus is God, again, doesn't make sense, cannot be found in the Bible. The Bible is corrupt. How are they going to preach anything to the Christians? So the new way of teaching Christians is to insult Islam, to hate Muslims, and to hate the Prophet of Islam. I hope the message is clear. Just wanted to warn everyone that this is not going to succeed. We will continue with the Adawah. Our work will continue. People will continue to come to Islam. We will continue to teach them about the beauty and the attraction of Islam, which speaks on its own terms. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum.